Hello friends, now we'll discuss other important component of IPM, that is pest management by modifying insect development and its behavior through both natural and synthetic chemicals. In this lecture, I am going to deal with the communication in insects, behavioral aspects of the insects, then semiochemicals, and pheromones, allylic chemicals, then chitin synthesis inhibitors, then afterwards attractant, repellents, and also antifidants. On this earth, each and every organism has developed its own communication system. In vertebrates, the communication system is through auditory and visual. But in case of insects, apart from auditory and visual, the another system of communication is through olfaction and also tactile. In insect, the communication system through olfaction, it is strong, and this olfaction behavior of insect can be well established, and this can be used in pest management programs. So insect behavior, it is through producing some chemicals either by insects and also some host plant species. Some of the volatile compounds and also non-volatile compounds produced by the plant species, actually they deter the insect species by changing its behavior. This was involved in the pest management strategy through trap cropping system. So another way of modifying insect, it is through food lures, and also some of the baits which are being used in the pest management program, both in household pest management and also field insects. However, even though we have a long history of adoption of this technology, but its adoption in agriculture system is slow. It is because of availability of cheaper chemicals which have broad spectrum activity against various insect pests, and at the same time they are cheap, they are quite convenient to handle, and thereby farmers, they opted the chemical protection than other means of protection. When they learnt about the more bad or ill effects of these broad spectrum insecticide, to quote one example here, when the DDT was used in USA, the same DDT residue was about 0.00002 ppm in the lake water. When the fish was taken out from the same lake, the magnification of this DDT was magnified to 15 times. So the residual toxicity of this hazardous chemical was accumulated in fishes, and thereby environmental protection agency, it seriously acted upon this DDT, and ultimately they banned this DDT product from the use in agricultural ecosystem, and started using the alternative management practices. Among them, it is one is manipulation of pest behavior. So it is one method which is based on the principles of ecology, since it doesn't have any ill effects on the environment, and it is going to save the natural fauna and flora also. So these chemicals which affect growth, development, biology, and the ecology of pest species can be differently looked into. So thereby these chemicals which are actually safe to the natural enemies, since they have low toxicity in the nature. So for their communication, insects most of the times they depend on chemicals and their chemical cues. So this phenomena was used in the pest management. The much work on the chemical technology, it is going on since 3 to 4 decades, and this resulted in the discovery identification and synthesis of specific chemicals so that regulate the and also mediate which affects the development and species behavior of the insect. Such chemicals, when they use, they cause premature death, that is abnormal molting or metamorphosis. At the same times, other chemicals, they are going to attract or repel towards the source. So this behavioral alteration of the chemical, it is defined by scientists called Foster and Harris during 1997. The manipulation of pest behavior is defined as the use of stimuli that either stimulate or inhibit a behavior, and thereby it is going to bring out some changes in the expression of the insects. So the another chemicals which changes the behavior of the insects, they are called semiochemicals. So the word semion, it is actually derived from a Greek word, that means to say a mark or signals. So those chemicals that are able to modify behavior of a insect in its perception, which is going to cause change its behavior at very low level, they are called semiochemicals. These semiochemicals can be divided into naturally secreted ones and which are not naturally secreted ones. So under naturally secreted semiochemicals, we have pheromones and also allelochemicals. So these pheromones, they actually communication between own species, and this is between intraspecific. That means between two different species. Again, in this we have allelomones, chiromones, synomones, antimones, and also mnemones. So in pheromones, we have two groups, that is releaser pheromones and also primer pheromones. So from the point of pest management, we have more information about these pheromones, which are being used since many years for modifying the insect pest behavior for the advantage of the pest management program. In next class, we are going to deal more about these pheromones and their application in the pest management program. Thank you.